You foolish human. Why don't you just start the main event already?
You're so impatient. Do you know that the final moments of your lives are just around the corner? Well, see ya. Doctor, it's all you now.
Dad! What are you gonna do to us now?
You might not know this about me, but I'm kind of a movie fanatic. Remember that one about the dinosaur clones? Well, that movie inspired me to create demon clones. And this time, I collected only the highest quality selves from those clones to create this one. The ultimate final weapon! The true final boss!
The true final boss?
Finally, the time has come. Disgaea will meet her.
So you know who it is? The true final boss?
Yes, she is the completed form of the final weapon that defeated Disgaea and cast her into Hades. The final weapon, Disgaea, perfect version. Her name is Disx.
So she is the main event? The true final boss!
She looks a lot like Miss Disgaea.
A lot? The only thing different about her is the color!
Was that a cost-cutting tactic by the creator? Explain this to us, lass.
Don't ask me! Go ask my dad if you really want to know!
Shut up, scum!
You! How dare you call my lord scum, being that you are a mere man-made monster?
What's wrong with calling scum scum? I am the most powerful true final boss, Lady Disx!
Disx!
Well, well, what a surprise. I didn't know who to expect, but I didn't think I was gonna see two of the punks I killed before.
Two?
Why do you keep getting in my way? Do you want to be killed again? Huh? Why is that? Disgaea? Fuka?
Ah, so it was you! You were the one who attacked me!
That's right. I killed you with my own hands.
That's two witnesses now, including your father. And this time, it's the killer herself. Lass, it's been proven already. You are already dead.
No, I am not! See? I'm here. I'm alive. Look!
So you haven't realized it, huh? How annoying. Okay, well, I'll just have to kill you over and over again until you accept it.
Be my guest.
Shut up! I am totally not dead, and this is just my dream, so it's impossible for me to die. That's right. Plus, Big Sis has Disgaea, and Disgaea will not let Big Sis die!
Listen to you, Disgaea. Have you forgotten how you were killed so pitifully after trying to keep up with my functionality?
Never. That memory is embedded inside Disgaea's memory chip. But Disgaea isn't the same Disgaea you faced back then. Disgaea will not lose!
Are you saying you've been training in Hades or something? Give me a break. You're kidding, right? You're just a prototype, a test model they created in the process of completing me! No matter how much stronger you've gotten, there's not even a 1% chance for you to defeat me!
That's not true! Disgaea is my little sister! Me, who's gonna be the ruler of Earth, and Disgaea, who's gonna be the strongest final boss! There is no way that this golden and gorgeous duo will lose to you!
Big Sis!
Oh, what What are you talking about? You're just a ghost, a dead human. Whatever, I'll just smash you, along with your soul, so you'll never be able to talk to me like that again. I won't let that happen. I'm not going to allow any more of this autocratic crap by humans.
If the entire human world becomes evil, Celestia will be out of business.
For our future profits, I back Miss Desko up entirely, and for free, for now.
All is for my lord. I will kill whoever stands in my lord's path to supremacy.
Jeez, none of you can just admit that you want to help me and Desko?
Everyone, Desko is so happy! Desko is feeling more energized. This must be the power of friendship. This is a great lesson for a final boss.
Mm-hmm. Finally, this is starting to feel like the main event. Everyone, let's win this battle! For Desko and the Lass!
Know your place, scum! I'll kill all of you if that is what you wish!
Essentially, I have to fight Desko again. How nice. This is actually... Don't worry, while it's Des-X, it's essentially just a different color of Desko. The final boss created by Dr. Kazumatsuri, the final bot version of Desko, Fuka's killer, pretty high HP. Gets attack bonuses from adjacent allies, and attack increased by 50%. Fortunately, she does not have her last skill, because that would hurt. This isn't really a tricky fight. It's just that those blocks in the back move, so... the blue and red panels alternate for being no entry. So right now, the blue is no entry. Next turn, the red will be no entry, and so on and so forth.
I'll show you!
Obviously, I can't reach with that skill.
Ready for me?
Was the boss hard? I couldn't say. However, deceptively, and something that you might want to take into account if you're going to try this battle yourself, is this battle is a two-parter. And you have no indication of that prior. So, you go into another boss fight right after this without being able to heal.
It's my turn.
So, watch out. That's not something they're going to tell you. They're going to keep you in the dark. Because they're assholes.
Thank you.
Alright, very few monster classes left to go over. We're on the Demon Beast, which is the Gargoyle. You know, those chest-like pieces. There's very little other than that to go over, and I know it's not on the map, so... the Gargoyle. You couldn't ask for a better honeypot than these guys. They have defensive stats and the abilities to help them survive enemy attacks as much as any non-evasive rival. For most of the game, these advantages make these guys extremely hard to kill. Combine Stone Statue, Stone Guard, and Stone Wall to make them a force of ultimate survival. At the beginning of the battle, deploy the monster and end your turn without having other characters deploy with them. Monsters approach to kill your lone demon beast, and these fools can be dispatched by your entire team on the next turn. By throwing your demon beast into other areas, you can continue luring targets towards you without giving up the advantage of increased defense. Stone Statue, his base ability, by the way, increases your defense by 10% per turn when choosing not to move. So you will get consistently better defense every single turn. The Demon Beast, or the Gargoyle, interestingly enough, is the only class that learns 5 abilities, as opposed to 4. Not sure why that is. It's a defensive specialist monster class. They match a change into an axe. They surprisingly can move 5 spaces for a unit that doesn't have any legs.
I'll show you.
They are neutral to all elements as well. Let's see. Their other abilities, the second one, Stone Guard, raises stats the closer this character is to their base panel. By what percentage that is, I'm not sure. But if it's a map where their enemies are very close to the base panel, then yeah, this would be helpful. If you're going to use him as a lure. The next one, Stone Piece, increases stats by 10% per time thrown in a single turn. That's a bit odd. I mean, theoretically, you could get that up to 90% in a single turn, which, admittedly, that's pretty nice, but you could probably be doing more damage with all your other units combined, not to mention, I think the stats will go back down the next turn. So, how useful that really is, I couldn't really tell you. Next is Stone Wall, which adds 30% to defense and resistance, but reduces your movement by 2. Honestly, that doesn't sound that horrible. Especially if you're going to equip the stat where your stats go up by being thrown anyway. So you can increase your stats by being thrown and have a 30% increase to your defensive stats at the same time. Not bad. You know, 30% is a pretty decent increase. And the last one is Gimmick Body. All aptitudes become 200%, but base stats are halved. Wait a minute.
Here I come!
Let me check something. Excuse me? That sounds familiar.
Ready?
That can't be. This is level 1, 2, 5. I don't know if this is true or not, but that's the exact same ability that the androids learn by themselves. This is probably a typo. I mean, maybe. I don't know. I made one, but I never checked the ability list. Oh, no. This is going to really piss me off. I can't trust this guy for shit. Oh, it's poisoning my brain. Oh, this guide is horrible! Oh, it's like the worst guide I've ever seen. And I'm basing my Let's Plays around it. What does that show about my judgment? Oh, this cannot be forgiven. I am appalled. Whatever. I'm not gonna read it. This is bullshit. Anyway, the Gargoyle. His aptitudes are HP 100, SP 90, Attack 115, Defense 120, Intelligence 115, Resistance 115, Hit 100, and Speed 90. Although, who can trust this guide? Who knows if those are accurate at all? Yes, I could just check the game, but for the sake of this joke, who knows if that's accurate or not? Take my information with a grain of salt. After the Gargoyle, we have the Guardian, the Nebiros, the Balrog, the Seth, and the Pazuzu. The Pazuzu has HP aptitude of 125, SP 115, Attack 140, Defense 145, Intelligence 140, Resistance 140, Hit 125, and Speed 115. So all of his aptitudes are above 100. That's nice, I guess. Pretty good overall. Nice and balanced. Surprisingly good intelligence. As for his attacks, Flying Press can hit 2 tiles away, although the power is F, so it's pretty weak. The next one is Burn Down, which has a fire element. The power is E, and I believe it hits a horizontal row of 3 right in front of you. This is almost a wholesale replacement for Flying Press. Increased damage, area of effect, and fire inclusion make it superior in almost every possible way. Unless, of course, the enemy is resistant to fire. Shocking Shock, the next one. Powers D, has a fixed area of effect. I think it's a cross. This move doesn't offer enough of an upgrade over Burn Down to warrant heavy upgrades. It's a decent skill, but it doesn't earn a place in your repertoire because it will be superseded by the next attack, Plasma Lorentz. The attack power is C, so average. element is star, and I believe it's a cross that goes up to 4 tiles away. No, not a cross, it's an X. By waiting just a bit longer, you end up with a skill worthy of heavy mana investment. Plasma Lorentz is pricey, but its heavier damage and superior area of effect make it a better place to spend your points compared with Shocking Shock. Okay. And then the match will change type into an axe. And the first one, Trance Axe. The power is E. The range is fixed. Not point blank though, so I think it's either. I think it's 3 spaces away. This magic chain attack is good for axe users because it lets them smack something that's 4 tiles away. Okay, so it's like rest in peace. This is ideal for closing the gap against an enemy that you just can't quite reach. And then finally, there's Graviton Hammer. Hits, I think, 5 enemies. And power is C, and when you want an axe user to slam an entire area, magic chain can give them the power to do so. So, all in all, personally, I don't care for the gargoyles. I'm sure they have their uses, but I never bother to spend much time with them. They have decent abilities, and actually pretty good aptitudes. I believe they could be pretty worthwhile in the end, and, but again, a proclivity for defense as opposed to attack means, overall, their usefulness will be relatively short-lived. And that's the gargoyle. Should you make them? If you feel like it. Huh. Everyone survived. Okay. So yeah, now time for my ultra combo! Here's the thing, I think because of this fight, when Fuka's magic change goes away, I can't use the wood golem in the next fight. I think that's how that worked. Alright, typically, Volcano should go first to lower her speed, then Fuka should go to lower her defense. And then the rest of the characters can pile on afterwards. Alright, that seems pretty good. Watch the damage pile! Dear God, that was good. Damn it! Guns first, people. I did not do these attacks in the proper order. You should go in ascending power. Dual canine. Just gotta do the dual canine fist. Use the dual canine fist. Woo! And she's gone. So, not bad, right? But wait a minute. What's this?
We did it! We defeated the true final boss! It's our victory! See? I told you we... the golden and gorgeous duo weren't gonna lose.
I doubt you two would have won that battle on your own. We helped you win, you know.
That was a lot of trouble.
Sure, true final bosses are a lot of trouble, I suppose.
No, I'm talking about the lass's father for creating that thing.
He created a final boss to destroy the human world. Does he hate humans as well?
He was a weirdo to begin with, but I didn't think he wanted to destroy everyone. Maybe he just went crazy after Mom died.
You don't know anything. You have no idea. You don't know a thing about your own father. His thoughts and motivation, nor the reason why he became one of the villains.
What's your problem? Why are you yelling at me?
You don't know anything. Just because you're his daughter, you expect that you can act however you want and still be loved? In comparison, Desko and I are only artificial beings. We'll never be his real daughters, no matter how much we want to be.
So, what's your point?
Shh, Miss Fuka. Just listen to what she has to say. She might just be...
I can't be his real daughter. I knew that from the start. But I still envied you. I hated you so much. So I killed you to make you disappear from this world. But you still had the nerve to come back afterwards. You're still trying to have Daddy all to yourself.
You? Really?
Desx, Daddy is also Big Sis's daddy. It's sad, but we're...
Shut up! Daddy is my daddy! He's mine and no one else's! Fuka, Desko, and your stupid friends, you're all eyesores to me! Die!
Huh? That's the reason you killed me?
Screw you! Seriously, you really pissed me off now! Daddy, Daddy! I have no idea what you find so great about that stupid old man! I'm gonna beat you up and put an end to your fantasies!
Honestly, I don't think that full potential meant anything.
Watch this!
Unless it means... There we go. She learned her final attack. Airs every Monday at 5 p.m. Don't miss it. Yep. Giant Desk X. Everything's virtually the same, just a bit better stats and bigger area of effects.
It's my turn.
Well, I knew exactly what I wanted to do. Can't reach. In a case like this, I really should lure her closer. And this is when I'm noticing, oh crap, my characters don't have full health.
Sorry about that.
Giant Desko versus Giant Desx! Woo! Just barely. But first, I gotta power her up. Surround her with allies.
Not gonna lose.
Let's see how high her attack gets. It was 1800, now it's 2100.
You all ready for this?
Brace yourself.
2700.
Still going up.
Gonna do Braveheart for some added oomph. Too bad I don't have a Beastmaster. Increase it by a lot more. Desko attack! That feels good. Not a whole lot of damage though. Interesting choice. I think I get a bit overzealous.
Take this!
This is going to require a lot of tricky positioning to get the optimum combo. I want to get characters next to her to increase her attack power, and also I want to be able to put characters in a position where they can still attack Desx herself for a combo.
Are you ready?
I have more power in my
And she's pretty much fully surrounded now. 3900. That's the max for right now. Doing Braveheart a second time will not actually do anything, because Braveheart will last for 3 turns. You can only use it again once it runs out. I'm going to check out what Prinny Kaiser X looks like. Nope. Just barely can't hit her. Cross Demon Rush, faux show. What I should really do is I should move Fenric next to Val, because I think I've exceeded Desko's max attack boost anyway, and that way I could hit with dual canine fists. But 2020 hindsight, what are you gonna do? Especially since that attack was useless. No! Triple sevens! Desko, you'll always be the original in my eyes. Damn it, that was two nicks in a row. Not in a row, but... Retreat! Fall back, men!
Ready for me? Dial!
Ooh, you see her eyes? Oh, she gets the critical. Okay, bye, Val and Giant Desko. Really gotta make this work with my remaining seven characters.
Here I come!
Position her as far away as possible for maximum damage. Alright, let's get this combo going. Perfect. Volcano should be placed right between Amiesel and Val, and Fenric, of course. I don't know why I'm not doing that. Thought did not occur to me, I guess. She must be weak to wind, since I'm using all these wind attacks. Fortunate, and I almost forgot Fuka. That should do it. That's my phone. Always a fan of big combos. What do I have to do? 9,300 damage or something? Damn Nyx. This one might do it. Oh yeah, that'll do it.
Here I come.
And that was the boss. Boom goes the dynamite. Thanks for watching.
What are you? You're just a human. A dead one to be exact. Where is all this power coming from? Fuka, damn! How did she power up like that?
It's no big deal. It's probably just an adrenaline rush or something.
That's not important. I'm just really mad right now.
You're mad? Please, there's no way I'll admit this defeat.
I still see the energy in her eyes. As expected from the true final boss.
That's right. Until I kill every single one of you, I won't.
Ah! Desex has begun to regenerate! I don't remember equipping her with that kind of function. This is amazing! You're amazing, Desex!
Amazing? Do you even know why she's able to do this, Dad?
No, not at all.
You're so stupid, Dad! You might be a genius scientist, but you're the stupidest man ever! If you weren't like this, this wouldn't have happened! Disgaea wouldn't have been thrown out!
I didn't have to die.
So you finally admitted it. It's about time.
Indeed. It's settled that you're a prinny.
Shut up! That's not the point right now! I'm talking about Dad!
After Mom died, you escaped into your work and left me all alone. You created Disgaea and Desex, but you ended up making them feel the same way I did. What are you doing, Dad?
Don't you care about anything besides your research? Don't you ever think about our feelings?
No, I...
Big sis, you don't understand. Daddy loves you.
How can I believe that?
Daddy talked about you all the time. Like how you wouldn't take baths with him anymore, how you treat his laundry like filthy objects, or how you stole money from him.
Miss Disgaea, those are just simple complaints. Is there anything more heartwarming?
Well, let me see. Oh, he bragged about how sweet you are at heart, even when you were in your rebellious stage in middle school. He still has the portrait of him that you drew when you were 5. He even showed it to Disgaea. Daddy's favorite story of you was when you two went to a summer festival when you were only 4 years old. He had to look for you for hours because you got lost, but you had already gone home by yourself. But still, Daddy was so proud of you for that. He said that you were already an amazing child by the time you were 4.
Not that I remember.
Everything he does is for you, including his research. You're the only one who doesn't know that.
No, you're lying. He focused on his research because he wanted to escape from everything after Mom died.
That was what Mommy asked Daddy to do, to continue his research, to make your wish come true.
My wish?
Me, Disgaea, the demon clones, we were all created for you! That's how much Daddy loves you.
No, that's not true!
Disgaea is right, Big Sis. Daddy loves you. He loves you with all his heart.
No way! I don't believe it! What's my wish anyway? I don't remember wanting this.
You don't? Oh, you used to throw big tantrums about it. Pestering me and Mom all the time. You said you wanted a little sister.
Oh, yeah. I did. But Mom died soon after that.
Big sis.
But seriously? You remembered that from so long ago? And created these little sisters for me, Dad?
That's right, Fuka. I created Disgaea and Desex just for you.
Thanks, Dad.
The final weapons, Disgaea and Desex, were not created to destroy the human world after all. They were the fruition of a father's love for his daughter, to make her wish come true. All of the misunderstandings that had piled up were resolved. And the defeated Disgaea was finally released from her destiny to be the final boss of the human world. This battle, where a pretty girl and the kinship between her family members had saved the human world and Netherworld, would lead to the improved pretty treatment movement in the future, which eventually led to Pretty War II. However, not being aware of future events, Fuka and her father simply enjoyed their reunion. They embraced each other, reaffirming their feelings of love and happiness.
Not! You mad scientist!
Aw, why not? I worked really hard for this.
Did you really think I'd be happy to have these freaking killing machines as my little sisters? The hell were you thinking?
But You're the one who wanted this. You said, I want a little sister. With advanced functionality, who was gonna help me take over the world?
So, you were trying to become a final boss for Fuka's sake, Disgaea?
Yes, all is for Big Sis.
And you're going to take over the world with Miss Fuka as the final boss?
Yes, Disgaea was created to help Big Sis take over the world.
Now I'm concerned.
They're lying! They're totally making things up right now!
I even have proof! Like the Christmas video! When you were five.
No! This isn't... You're just all trying to trick me! Disgaea has seen that too! Big Sis was so cute!
Now I see. I didn't think you were normal, but I had no idea you possessed such ambition. It's only natural that you fell to Hades.
This is quite amusing.
This isn't funny! No, no way! This can't be real! This is a dream, I know it! This is a nightmare!
Enough fooling around, bastards! The hell's this farce? Fight, Desex! One more time! Kill them all! Then all of humanity!
No way. This is getting kind of boring. Plus, I'll only listen to Daddy. Why didn't you do it yourself if you wanted so badly?
You... Who do you think funded your development, you useless puppet?
He's showing his true nature. This farce suits you rather well.
Judge Nemo! Your ambitions have been crushed! Your Hades of destruction will never happen!
My ambitions have been crushed?
You've got it all wrong, Valvatores! I've been setting up devices everywhere to prepare for humanity's destruction for a long, long time. You guys have only awakened another dream, a nightmare of demolition! The destructive might of Hades!
Nightmare of demolition!
That's right. I'm lighting a giant firecracker. The big round moon is gonna go kaboom!
An unbelievably shocking revelation is dropped on us after we suppressed a foolish rebellion in the human world.
Is he really going to blow up the moon?
The truth is...
Did you know that various kinds of fish larvae are used in Chirimenjaco?
I thought Chirimenjaco was the name of an actual fish.
And there's more. It's the same deal with Kamagishirasu.
Ah! I thought the same thing about Kamagishirasu.
That's right. Shirasu usually refers to any kind of fish larva, but the larva of Japanese anchovies are the most commonly eaten shirasu.
Okay, so?
Next time, final episode, the Sardine Galaxy. Space sardines conquer the Sea of Stars.
It's another page in the history of sardines.
I will stop the destruction of the moon.